darkness. The smell of brimstone, the aroma of death. Tasting your last breath, may God lay your soul to rest. But it is he who was amongst the dead, his spiritual being, restless with unfinished business. May God be his witness. How can you betray her? You told her you would be forever by her side. You would never leave, but your life was blown away into the atmosphere like the autumn leaves. Living a desperate life in desperate measure. Coney leads you into eternal silence on a stockade with no leisure. Now she's isolated with no one to turn to. Those that you can find and embrace as family and friends became competitors and rivals at the end. Can I get an amen? They always said keep your friends close, but your enemy closer. Golden words to always remember, cause you got dealt with bloody and dirtier than the old Jake love. But the one who got it worse was your true love. Yes, your true love. Your girl from afar, in the other side, as she try to survive, going to school in the weekend, and at the same time working a 9 to 5, while your partner in crime, push up on her more hard than 2 Siamese connected from the spine, telling her to quit.
There's no need for all that bullshit. I buy you clothes, shoes, jewelry, even pay for the aerobic class to keep that sexy body in fit.
But she kept strong, and rolled her eyes, continued walking, and said I'm doing fine. Go search for a real chick ahead for your trophy and prize. He got heated, you could see the flame in his eyes.
Aye, mama, but you could've had your cake and eat it too, plus a piece of the pie.
So he whispered under his lips,
nobody plays out little Mitch. You'll get yours tonight, you stuck up bitch.
Now you're frantic, trying to figure out a way to keep it from harm. But you sense soon she'll be covered below the black storm. You never cared or even thought about God in your whole life. But you get on your knees, yell and pray to the heavens above. Please send someone to help my true love. Please send someone to help my true love.
Dressed in black in the alleyway next to her house, quiet as a mouse. Mary puts up beside her home, all known of her tragic fate, being lured to her death all because of animosity and hate. You yell out her name, demanding her to get back in her car. You must run, you must escape, but it's no use, she can't hear you, it's too late. Little Mitch jumps out of the shadow with a face expression that's hollow. Mary screams from the terror, and he grabs her by the hair, puts her down to the ground and says,
bitch, don't make a sound.
She said, please Mitch, don't do this, you're fucking sick. He just laughed and said, I know, and sort of threw knuckles at her lips, covered her mouth, ripped off her skirt from her hips. He started to rape her, there's nothing you could do to save her. He releases his lust and looks at her straight in the eyes and said,
I can't let you live, it's time for you to hush.
Little Mitch pulls out his blade. Mary's in a state of shock, in a psychological daze. Little Mitch looks around to see if anyone near, then he starts to cut Mary's throat from ear to ear.